And we're kind of an agency, we work with those agencies to try to make sure that the latest technology can be used to improve healthcare, public safety, transportation.
So our mission statement, as it says here, our next generation applications and services,
though it's not being done right now, we kind of qualify it there,
leveraging advanced networking technologies
in smart and connected communities. And why networking technologies? Because this is all about knowing where things are, where people are, the PICOs, you know, what's going on in the world, sensing all of those things. We need a new next generation internet if we are going to go and have all of these sensors, all this data, if we're going to become more of a knowledge economy, if we're going to be able to have the efficiencies in transportation, if we're going to do a better job in education and healthcare. So it turns out there are a few places in the country that happen to have really excellent next generation internet structures. Utopia, Google Fiber, right here in this area. So this is one of 25 areas in the country that have something that's really outstanding in the way of an advanced networking technology. And the question is then, what can we do if we have Utopia, what's the one in Provo now called? It used to be part of Utopia that got sold and has a different name. Anyway, if we have gigabit style infrastructure, what can we do that you couldn't do if you lived in Omaha and you didn't have a gigabit infrastructure? And we'd like to go and advantage those 25 areas of the country that have that gigabit infrastructure to do things that can't otherwise be done, and then make everybody else envious, which will mean that it will grow and we'll have more and more advanced networking infrastructure. And this will really improve the economic competitiveness of the United States, which then raises wages, which means better quality and standard of living, because we're taking better advantage of the information and knowledge we have.
So we have here some of the examples. The person in the upper left is doing a 3D stereoscopic view. This is a US Ignite program that's meant for helping biologists and people in the field of medicine be able to better visualize things that are too small to otherwise be seen. And you can see it's kind of been blown up here, so it's human scale. The middle one is a drone. This comes from the University of North Texas. And the idea is, how can we better fight firefighters? Fight forest fires, sorry. How can we better fight forest fires? And we lose several firefighters every year to not knowing that the fire was catching up on them, because we do not have connectivity ubiquitously in the forests when they're burning. Now we go and we have these walkie-talkie radios, and if you happen to be in line of sight, we can go and get there. But if you're over the ridge, you can't do that. So the answer is send up a drone to be a repeater so that we can go and have communications at all times to all firefighters. That's the US Ignite project. Improve the quality of life of the firefighters and get the fire out up earlier. On the top right are these cute little gigabots. These guys kind of roam around and they're used for lots of things. For example, one of the things that these gigabots can do is take a senior living facility, somebody may have an apartment, and maybe once an hour it goes and wanders around. It's kind of like a Roomba, except it's got lots of sensors on it. Discovers if anyone's fallen, needs help because they can't get up. Checks for carbon monoxide. Checks for burners were left on the stove. Sees if there's a broken window and there's cold air rushing in because it has an infrared camera. And how can you do this inexpensively? Well, the way that you do this thing inexpensively here with the gigabots is that you take the brain and you locate that someplace else, and this is just the sensors and the motors and the battery. So it's a very cost-reduced robot that does the intelligence remotely. Now, if you're going to have the intelligence needed all the time, you might as well pay to put it there, but if you're only going to run it around the apartment once an hour, we can go and divide the cost of the intelligence by 30, and then just have these very inexpensive robots. On the bottom left is a microscope. This is a 4K microscope with a Hollywood camera mounted on top that can be controlled by students in classrooms. And these little round things there are called diatoms. They're found in Pacific Ocean water. And the students can go and remotely move the stage of the microscope, focus it up and down, and see in real time what's going on the screen in 4K. It has to have very fast response times because when the student says, change the focus to higher, oh, stop right there, we have to go and get it to the microscope, get the microscope to stop moving, get that image back to the student. So the student thinks it takes zero time in order to stop that focus knob to freeze that image. So very little latency necessary to do that. The middle of the bottom indicates that we have made great gains in fiber, but there are equally great gains to be made in wireless. So wireless is going to be very, very important. That's a logo for a new program at US Ignite called Platforms for Advanced Wireless Research. This is a program being sponsored by the National Science Foundation. It's a $100 million program, $50 million coming from industry, $50 million from the National Science Foundation. And they're going to eventually establish four platforms, four research test beds for very advanced wireless throughout the United States. And the first two of those will be announced toward the end of March, we think is very likely. And that's going to provide the communities that have that kind of advanced networking technology some additional advantages, where they can take advantage of that and do some very, very interesting things. So that's another project over leveraging advanced networking technologies and helping make those communities even smarter and more connected. And on the bottom right is a chart, it's a map I'll show you later. Those are the 25 existing smart and connected communities. Here are the people working with US Ignite. You can see a number of commercial companies up here, regional networks, places that are really helping us in various ways. We've had a lot of support from Google, from Cisco, from Juniper, HP, JDSU, Florida Lambda Rail, Internet 2. We're all working with us to try to make this vision come to pass. It's a national vision. So what are our strategic goals in our Smart Gigabit Community Program? And one of those Smart Gigabit Communities is this Wasatch Frontier. And I'm trying to recruit you today to think about what you can do and how you can help make this happen. So the strategic goals for US Ignite are to create a self-sustaining ecosystem of these Smart Gigabit Communities. We provide connectivity between communities, we provide training, we provide seed grants to get things started. We tell you what's going on in other Smart Gigabit Communities so you can adopt their best ideas. They'd like to know what your best ideas are. They'd like to go and take your PICOs and deploy them in their communities as well. We'll spread that message around. A second strategic goal listed there is to transition government-funded research into smart community benefits. That's what we're trying to do. So what's our formula? The formula that seems to be working, and we've been at this now for 5 years, the formula is that we